Hello again. In this video, I'm going to walk us through how to create an activity within Seesaw. So let's get started. From my class, you can see I'm on the class, so I land on the journal page. I have the option of navigating over, yes, I know about students, to activities. It's this light bulb here. Think of activities as anything that you would ask your students to engage in. A worksheet maybe, creating a video, reading aloud. There's lots of options. So I'm going to select activities. And when I get to activities, it's going to have me browse the activities library. So I'm going to go over here and I can browse the library, but that's for another module. I'm going to go to my library. And I'm going to come down to this button here on the left-hand side, and I am going to create an activity. Now, as a teacher, I may have so many activities that I create over time, and that's why you'll notice up here at the top that I can search my own library of activities that I've created or that I have added and assigned to my students. So I'm going to go over to create a new activity. The first thing that I'm asked to do is name it. So I'm going to give my name Drop the Mop, because this is a reading activity. I can type in some instructions for the student. For our non-readers, I can also add a voice instruction. So I'm going to do that. When I click on voice instructions, sometimes the very first time, I have to enable it up on the top. Then I'm going to click this button here. Students, please read the passage to a family member out loud and then answer the questions on the right-hand side of the page. It'll process. It'll let me re-listen to it. I can delete it if I don't like it. I can download it too and save it to my local device. I can also add a multimedia instruction. So this is a picture or something else that I may want to add that I want kids to write on. For me, I'm going to add a student template. This allows the students to write directly on top of my worksheet or my reading passage in this case. They can add photos, they can add drawings, they can add notes, they can even record themselves if they need to. I do have more options, so I'm going to go ahead and add a template. When I add a template, I can add a photo, I can add a drawing that I create myself, I can add a video, I can upload a video or a photo or a file that's in my Google Drive or anywhere on my computer. I can do a note or I can do a link to a website of some kind. I'm going to do upload. When I upload, I can select from my computer or I can select from Google Drive. Those features show up because I signed in as a teacher within the Google Drive world. I'm going to just drag something that I've saved to my computer and drop the file right here. The file is now going to load up and I'm going to have the ability to edit it and add things to it, additional pieces. I can come in here and grab the microphone and start recording. I can do a lot of things. I can also add another page. For me, it's already created. So I'm just going to come up to the top and I'm going to select the green check mark in the top right-hand corner. Now I come back to this page because it's just attached it. And I have a few more options. If I select down below here, I can add teacher notes. Just in case I was going to share this with other teachers and add it to the community library, I can type in specific notes that only the teachers can see and not the students. And I also can add skills to this assignment or activity. So I can give the standard or the skill that this meets if I would like to. I'm not going to do that for this purpose, but I'm going to click save. Once I've reached saved, I can assign this to my students. I see everything they see, and I'm going to go over here and assign. When I assign this to a student, I can schedule this out, or I can assign it to multiple classes. I only have one, so I'm going to assign it to one. It gives me more information about it. Now it's your turn. This time, I want you to go in to your Seesaw account and create an activity. And then in the discussion below, what are some possible ways that you can see using activities with your students in the fall? What are some sample activities? And then read other people's discussions. What activities are they thinking about? It might give you an idea.